I am going to be a part of a panel in just a little bit at a very good friend's space, a woman-centered space. It used to be operated by four black women. I'm going to have to ask her who all's a member, who all's kind of cooperatively operating the space now. But I need to put on these dollar store eyelashes. I'm wearing eyelashes to try to make myself feel better because over the last couple of days, it has been revealed that a well-known poet has been preying on women, some of whom I know, some of whom I didn't. I mean, they published a narrative on the Vita website, and those revelations have really, really rocked me. To see it all collected in one place and to realize that this man, this black man, had been a serial predator and that he had been massaging people into positions of submission and picking his prey carefully. Presenting himself as someone who wanted a partnership and using those intimate spaces to rape, brutalize, demean, threaten, stalk, all of those things. The next level of hell that occurred with all of this, and it's not even a comparable level of hell to the victims because I wasn't victimized by him. But for my part, the next level of hell was the really strategic silences of straight black men, straight black male poets. And I have really been grieving, accepting that black men just don't like me as much as I like them. This isn't the first time that I've allowed my mind to broach that idea. But, you know, this is the first time that it's really gotten me down like this. So I need some mama love. I need to go to this space and tell the truth and have other women tell me the truth. So let me pull together my eyelashes so I can feel real cute, and I will talk to you in a bit. Completed look. Little nappy hair glory. Earrings that I got from a really cute Afrocentric shop, which isn't on Grand anymore since the post Von Derrick Myers problems and post righteous response to Michael Brown. And so I'm ready to go.
What is your name, gorgeous?
My name is Eileen Chung.
Eileen Chung from Brooklyn. Right here in St. Louis in the Lou. And right now she is shepherding an event at the Yeyo, what's the whole name of the organization?
Arts Collective.
Yeyo Arts Collective, which is a woman-centered arts collective. What is tonight about?
So tonight is the first FEMININE PRONOUN Series, where we're going to be focusing on artistry and motherhood. Okay. And where we have our three featured artists, who are both mothers and artists themselves.
Yeah, Cameron, I'm really excited to be here. I'm always trying to support. I'm sad and disappointed that Dale won't be here. So Dale, when you see this later, you weren't here and I was a little salty about that.
This is what a delirious little girl looks like at night. We really shouldn't be up this late, but I'm going to go ahead and read. What's the name of your book, sweetie?
The Legend of the Indian Paintbrush.
Okay.
See?
Awesome. By Tommy DePola.
He's probably from a different place to DePola.
And I am going to read to this little girl.
with my raggedy glasses on. I did my artist mommy thing, went to my panel and spoke, and now it is time for me to do my mommy thing, where I read then to a pretty little girl.
She can read her books and do her artist thing.
Yeah, girl.
It's the morning time. I just made an important life decision that I want to share with my son. I can no longer support Hillary Clinton. These things have happened that I must share with you.
Have you joined the Bernie Sanders side?
Here's the thing. That's the only other side to join. But I'm not excited about supporting one more white male candidate in the 400-year line of white male candidates.
It sucks, doesn't it?
It does.
I just really hope that Hillary Clinton will be our first woman president after our first black president. That would have been awesome.
So what happened? What made you have to support Bernie?
Bernie actually fights for more. He's not so conservative.
Oh, wow.
He's not so conservative.
Wow.
He fights for... free public college.
Give me the phone.
He's anti-war. But the problem is, I don't think that's actually against him, because a lot of people are going to think he's like a radical. Oh, he's a communist. I'm not going to vote for him.
Well, he already said he supports the democratic socialism.
Yeah.
Which is awesome. But, you know, what happened to me is, you know that poem I always read? Called Matthew, about my friend who passed away of HIV.
Oh, I remember that.
Yep. Well, she was at the funeral of Nancy Reagan the other day, and Hillary Clinton said that the Reagans opened up the conversation about HIV. But they were the reason why so many people died. Mm-hmm. Ronald Reagan wouldn't even say AIDS or HIV. Clinton. And then this happened.
Nancy,
this happened right here. The woman on my totem, Bell Hooks.
In the stage of her politics, that I can no longer be a Hillary Clinton supporter in the name of feminism. There are certain things that I don't want to co-sign in the name of feminism that I think are militarist, imperialist, white supremacist. Whether they are, conducted by women or
men. I don't know if y'all know how I feel about Bell Hooks, but, when she says it, people used to say God said it, I believe it, and that's enough. That's how I feel about Bell Hooks, so.
We are coming to the Missouri History Museum to rehearse for our women's poetry reading that's going to happen in a couple days. I have my handsome son with me and my gorgeous daughter. We're here.
Greetings.
We're doing quite well. You have to introduce yourself to the camera. You know I'm always
running.
Girl, that child is always running.
The hostess with the most.
The hostess with the most. And what is your name, beautiful?
Do-A-Y.
Frazier.
Frazier. Thank you.
And what is the name of this program?
I Rise, Women's History Month tribute to women poets.
Okay, fantastic. So there are going to be lots of local women poets, and we're each going to be reading from someone we respect. I've chosen Gwendolyn Brooks. And then we'll read a little bit of our own stuff. So, yes. Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
It's going to be, we're going to raise the roof.
We're going to raise the roof,
on
honey.
Tuesday, March 15th, 2016.
Yes! David A.N. Jackson, St. Louis Institution, one of the godfathers of the spoken word scene, certainly. I don't know a whole lot about it. You know what I'm saying about St. Louis's spoken word scene? I'm kind of new to being a permanent resident of the metro. But I will say this, that you really can't do anything without David A.N. having something to do with it. Tell us just a little bit about your artistic process, how you got started, that sort of thing.
Wow. How I got started. I guess the short story of this would be I got started, I created and carved the drum for my daughter for her first birthday.
Okay.
For her naming ceremony. And
How long ago was that?
She was born in 89.
So oh, 89. That was a good year.
This, mm-hmm. I've always heard music in the spaces. The thing of, I guess I've heard the improvisation. And so, drums, I've kind of gravitated toward them, but also I worked them differently, I think, than a lot of other musicians I work with.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
In the sense that as a poet, I interpret the words and create the colors.
Okay. So if I look, so I'm on Google Plus and I have Gmail. So if I just search David A.N. Jackson, I can find your contact information?
You should be. I've said this a couple of years ago. I'm Googleable.
Okay.
Just David A.N. Jackson.
David A.N. Jackson.
This is how St. Louis works its way into my heart.
Mandela.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, Nelson Mandela, girl.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Now, that's somebody who went to the wall for the people. 27 damn years. For real. Like, this is happening.
Right.
And you know what? Where's my... I don't even think that this light is working out here. I'm gonna go ahead and end my video. This is my 7th video, I think, of my little series. And I think I'm gonna end it here. On Cherokee Street, having fun with my buddy Francine. Woo!
We are hanging.
Let me get some video of you by Madiva.
Okay.
Nelson Mandela.
To the wall.
Had the soul of a poet. He went to the wall for the people.
To the wall.
Most definitely. Okay, now get me.
Wait, I can't see anything. Oh, wait. Wait. Can't see anything? Wait, there we go. It was zoomed in really far. Okay, there we go. Okay, wait. Do the kissing again.
Okay, let me kiss him.
There's some kissing. Yes, ma'am.
I love you, Nelson Mandela.
But y'all, look at the detail on this thing, though. That's
it's the
crazy.
Awesome. And somebody vandalized it not too long ago, but they came in and tried to cover it up.
Oh, my God.
Their vandalization.
That's so beautiful.
It is.
Holy shit. Damn. Nice.